Since I uploaded the video tutorial on how to use SIM800L, I got so many questions asked. The SIM module is really popular because the cheap price and the small size. Using the SIM module is easy, but sometimes it's not that easy. Well, I mean, maybe not that easy. Sometimes a little bit tricky. So if you ever had difficulties with this SIM module, then this video is right for you. So here's a video about the SIM800L troubleshooting guide. We will try to find what's the problem step by step with your SIM module until we found the solution. So make sure to watch this video till the end. There are some steps that we will try to do in order to find the problem. They are wiring, power supply, SIM check, network registration, and signal quality. Okay, let's start with wiring. In this video, I will use the Arduino Uno. You can use Arduino Nano the same way. And if you are using Arduino Mega, you can have a little bit different on serial communication. Since SIM800L module uses serial communication, then we have the RX and TX pins. So RX to receive data and TX to transmit data. The right connection we should use is the RX of SIM connected to TX of Arduino, and the TX of SIM should be connected to TX of Arduino. Because the receiver should meet the transmitter and the transmitter should meet the receiver. So yes, it's crossed. In this video, I use pin 3 of my Arduino as RX and pin 2 as TX. So here's the wiring diagram. This is a simple thing, but sometimes it is confusing. Once you are confident with the wiring, let's move to the power supply. So from the datasheet, we know that the SIM module will save, I mean works correctly if we give 3.4 volt to 4.4 volt and 2 amp current. So according to the datasheet, you can just connect 5 volt of your Arduino to this module. Even sometimes it just works. When I made this video, I tried to connect phases of this module to 5 volt and that works. But maybe it does not save for a long run. So I will use a full fault source by using step down to decrease voltage from a 12 volt power supply. Now I have this 4 volt and more than 2 ampere power source. Before we connect the power, insert the SIM card first. And this is the right position of SIM card. Let's connect the power to SIM module, 4 volt to VCC and ground to ground, and also don't forget to connect the ground of Arduino to the power supply ground. Here's the complete wiring diagram. Wait, before we continue the video, you can make me really happy by subscribing to this channel and tap the bell so you won't miss new video from me. Now you should see the LED is blinking. This means that this SIM module has powered. At first, it will blink every second. That means that this module is trying to reach the network and try to register at the network operator. Then in some seconds, if the registration is successful, it will blink slow, about 3 seconds worth. Now, open the Arduino IDE and upload the sketch. This sketch will forward what we type in serial monitor to the SIM800L module. And if there is a replay from the SIM module, this sketch will print the SIM800L replay to the serial monitor. And if you are using Arduino Mega, you don't have to use the software serial. You can use serial 1, serial 2, or even serial 3. You can download the sketch too, link in the description below. Once the upload is complete, open the serial monitor. Don't forget to choose both NL and CR, and just use the baud rate to 9600. This is the safe baud rate for software serial. Now, time to test the communication between Arduino and SIM800L. SIM800L and most GSM module devices are using AT command. So what is an AT command? I simply define AT command as command that start with an AT. So I will type AT and press enter. Now you should see the reply OK. If you are not getting this reply, don't continue. Then we have a problem found. Maybe your wiring is not correct, or maybe your cable is broken, or maybe your SIM module has broken. If you got this reply, then you are good to go. Make sure you put the SIM in the right direction. It's like this. A wrong position can make the SIM unreadable. Now, if you are sure that you put the SIM in the right position, then continue. We can check the SIM is read by typing in the serial monitor AT plus SIPIN question mark. If you got a response already, the SIM card is fine, then you are good to go. If you got a reply C plus not ready, then you have to stop here. Something wrong with your SIM. It does unreadable. You can check the position, or you can try to put SIM card to your phone and make sure that your SIM card is in good condition. Once you got the reply OK, now let's check the network registration. Before we check the registration, we can check the information first. So how do we check the network information? We can use AT plus COPS equals question mark. Wait for a second, and you should get the list of network operators in your area. For example, here in Indonesia, I got 51089 Indosat Telkomsel and Xcelcom. Now we have able to get the operator list. Let's continue to network registration. To check if our SIM already registered or not, we need to type AT plus CREC question mark. And if it reply plus CREC 0,1, then it's mean our SIM already registered and we are good to go. But if it's not, you can see the full list here. 2 means not registered, 3 means registration denied, and so on. When the SIM card is not registered to network, you can see also at the LED that it is blinking once every second. But when your SIM card is registered successfully, you should see that LED is blinking once every 3 seconds. When you are sure your SIM card is fine but it's not registered to the network, sometimes it caused by your power supply. Your power supply doesn't have enough power to power the SIM800L. So if you are using step down like me, you can increase the voltage. Sometimes it helps. Wait for some seconds and you should get your LED blinking slowly, once every 3 seconds. Now if you are already registered to network, we should continue. We can check the signal quality. We can use AT plus CSQ. So we got a reply. The first value is the signal quality. We can see the full list here and what that means. If you can make it here, then you should have no problem anymore with your SIM module. We can start to use the SIM to send SMS, make a call, or even connect to the internet. So I want to test to send a message. Here's the command I use to send a message. If you want a detail about tutorial how to send a message or make a call with the SIM800L module, you can watch my another video. link in top right corner, or you can find in the description below. Now let's try an internet connection. When the SIM module blinks really fast like this, it means that we have successfully connected to the GPRS. If you want a detailed tutorial on how to use this SIM module with internet connection, you can also watch my another video, link in the description. So this is the end of the video on SIM800L troubleshooting guide. Don't forget to subscribe, so it will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you and see you in another video.